The movements that should be included in shadow wrestling, one, I should be maintaining a nice stance, whether it's square or whether it's sugar foot. I should be on my toes. Now, what I want to focus on is, one, a lot of activity. So in the course of a wrestling room, you can see behind me we have some more space here. When you shadow wrestle, the mistake is to stay in one area. As an athlete, I want to move from this side of the room to the middle of the room, to the right side of the room, behind me in the room. I'm moving in all directions. So don't get in the habit when you're teaching or drilling to stay in one place. And the movements should be left and right, laterally here. I move. I also should work on footwork coming forward, coming backwards, and then there should always be little pivots in there where I step and I circle, and I step and I circle. So here, just a quick little drill, the motion, and on top of that, it should be here, left. Another aspect that we want to put in is our sprawl and our penetration steps. So here, our sprawl obviously would be arch, thighs heavy on the mat, pop back up into that nice stance. Again, we're back to moving. I can also tie the two together. I can sprawl, and now I pop up to that shooting stance, and I fire that shot off. Always keep your hands involved. Don't sit here like a statue. You can move your hands when you shadow. So I'm here, I picture an arm drag, and it makes my feet circle. Arm drag the other side, my feet circle. Fake, move my hands. Swing single here. You know, so these are all motions that I can go through. So a quick little demo incorporating all those things here. Move around the room, use your arms, use your hands, put your sprawl and your shots in there, and never come out of that stance.